Third is in Gwalior, this is 10 kilometers. So this fort founded by the Maharaja Surat Sen in the 6th century. Last king is Jayaji Rao Sindhya. Between 110 kings ruling about the fort. They had a different 7 dynasty. So dynasty number 1 we call Kushbaha. The descendant of Sar. They were Hindu and they were Rajput. They start 6th century to 11th century. Same dynasty they made boundary wall or some temple. So from that corner there is 2 temple is very famous inside the fort. They name Sas Bahu Mandir. It means mother-in-law and daughter-in-law temple. So that 2 temple built by Maharaja Mahipal 1093 near about 11th century, 1000 year old. So Maharaja mother they believe Lord Vishnu, then this temple is Vishnu temple. But after 3 years Maharaja take married his wife coming to believe Lord Shiva. So there is small temple is Shiva. So mother or wife they believe the different god, that's why they have a different temple. But each other the relation, mother-in-law and daughter-in-law, that's the normal they are Vishnu or Shiva temple. But after Mughal come, they destroyed the statue, so this time people not used to pray, just protect them. Then second dynasty arrived here, Patihal. So that time one Maharaja, the name Mir Bhoj, who taken to married in South Indian style lady. South India one place name was Telangana. So Telangana one more temple, Telika Mandir. So that building architecture total South Indian style, like in Madurai temple, Meenakshi temple, Gopuram temple. So that is architecture special name, Dharvadiyan architecture. But that is also Vishnu. After Mughal come, there is also destroyed itself. Then third dynasty arrive here, Tomar. Tomar is not originally from Gwalior. Tomar originally from Delhi. They arrive in Gwalior about 13th or 14th century. First they made Jain statue. When you climb up, you have seen the many statue on the rock.
Yes.
The all statue built by the Maharaja Dungren Singh. He was the grandfather of this Maharaja. So he was not Jain, he was Rajput, but he liked Jainism. That's why they built the statues. And after his descendant, Man Singh, who built this beautiful palace. After the Man Singh, this fort 1516, captured by the Ibrahim Lodi. Ibrahim Lodi, he was the son of Sikandar Lodi. Dynasty Lodi arrived from Turkey, from the Turkestan. That's why in Delhi there is Lodi Garden, Lodi Doom, so Lodi Road. And after the Lodi, because first battle of Panipat, Babur was come. So the Babur defeated the Lodi, then Babur was come, they captured this fort. So all the statues they faced destroyed by the Babur, because Babur they don't like his statue. Yeah. So 1526 to 1760, they fought under of Mughal. That time Agra used as a capital and Gwalior Fort was used as a state prison. That's why one time Jahangir arrived Agra to Gwalior with the 52 prisoners king. That time one king named Guru Hargobind. He was the 6th number guru of Sikh. You know Sikh religion they have a 10 guru, but this guru number 6. So Jahangir doing punish but guru all the time doing the prayer for the god. So one time Jahangir very impressed. He ordered I am free for you. But he's asking I am not going alone. If you want I am going all my friend, all the Rajput kings. So Jahangir they had a one condition. How many prisoners they touch your cloth that king going with you. So that time he made one new shirt. Behind they have a big cloth. So same time all prisoners they hold the shirt with the guru. And they used to free from this fort. That's why inside the fort campus, from that area there is one Sikh temple. So temple is new, only 40 year old. But the story is 400 year old. So this is the building where you are looking. There is many pillars. So like in 15th century time of Man Singh, this is Shiva temple. But time of Jahangir, a statue took from outside the fort after they used punish room. So one king, one pillar put it by the ropes and do the palace like a torture place. So they used to free from this building. So all the Sikh people come to see the Sikh temple, then they come to see this building. Because this is the time of Jahangir, this is a jail. So I am saying 1526 to 1760 under of Mughal. 1761 here arrived Sindhya family. Sindhya is still living in the city. But Sindhya is not originally from Gwalior, they are originally from Maharashtra near Mumbai. So this is called Maratha dynasty, but they were Hindu. After the Sindhya, because 1843 Sindhya against to the English, they do the fight. That time Sindhya going lose, British going victory, they do the compromise. Then they start the rule. That's why 1857 in India start the independence fight. That time Queen Jhansi here, Sipai mutiny here. That time Maharaja Sindhya, they not support the government, they support for English. So that's why Queen Jhansi died in Gwalior. So after Queen Jhansi died, but the English, they were very happy Maharaja Sindhya, so Maharaja owned palace in the city. That palace they built after 1857, they built that building 1874. That's why by the English they're going to support him, they built the big palace. So now in the city palace there is 400 rooms, Italian architecture. But the 27 rooms they use as a museum. So there is England furniture, France furniture, Italian furniture. As a tourist there is a lot of things. But maybe that time they support in India, by the English they don't give anything. So nowadays the palace is the private palace of Maharaja Sindhya and this fort under of government. So you are looking here is beautiful painting outside. You are looking there domes. Olden time all this tower used to covered by the copper plate and had used gold cover. This kind of things they write in Babur upon Babur Nama book. So before it is more beautiful. But after other Mughal come, so all the gold and copper take out. Because after this palace also used like a prison. You are looking outside painting. There is two big rooms. In center, a small room. Inside the screen, there is elephant there. See the elephant?
Yes.
Just back side of elephant or front of elephant, there is banana plant. Now you are going right side, up line. There is one tiger. See the tiger?
Yeah.
And right corner, last three color, where the one tail going up, two leg behind, face not clear, there is lion. Down yellow line, duck. And see the left tower. Upside there is not a doom. Left one. Just see the left side tower. And now you are coming downside. Blue color. Inside the blue color, they are designed like a U. So there is two crocodile head going up. In center, the lotus flower they're holding in the mouth. So downside, the crocodile. And you are coming second tower. Now you are coming down in blue color. There is two green parrot. So elephant is the vehicle of rain god Indra. Indra is the god of monsoon. Tiger, the vehicle of goddess Durga, the symbol of power. Banana plant, the color is green. Green called in Hindi, Hara, Hariyar name of Lord Vishnu. Duck is the vehicle of goddess Saraswati. Crocodile is the vehicle of river god Ganga. Parrot, the symbol of love. Or lion, we call in Hindi, Singh. So all the Rajput behind the name, they call Singh. Like this Maharaja name is Man Singh. So all animal and trees are Hindu religion. This is pure Hindu architecture building. Now this building, left side tower, upside not built doom, that is new actually. This tower destroyed by the Britishers, 1857, time of Sipahi Mutiny. That time they used to bombard it by the cannon. So this tower going to destroy. Now this tower rebuilt again, 1892 by the Sindhia dynasty. That's why they not build the dooms from up. So that's why they made uncompleted. Now when we are going to just there, you can see there, in new crocodile there is 2 feet like this. And the round shape. In old crocodile there is only 1 foot and the flat. And this stone is new and there is old. Then you can see upside, there is green one banana plant. So you can see the new banana plant, there is using pieces, tiles. And there is light color. See the old banana plant from up. They all are dark color, painted the Aminaka River. This kind of color in older time they use in jewelry work for the necklace, bangles, rings. This color also made in Gwalior. And this is original color. This Maharaja was 9 wives only. But 8 wives they were Rajput. They belong to royal family. They are the same caste. They are living inside. But after the 8 wives, Maharaja take 9 married. So wife number 9, lower caste. Belong poor family. But she is very beautiful. Very brave. So Maharaja take married with her. Then they build separate building for her from downside of the fort. So this fort has been 2 gates. Now you are coming. This is Uruvai gate. People came by car and buses. This is maintained by the British. Just near the palace one way going down. So there, here is first gate we call elephant gate. Maharaja goes with elephant and horses. They're going down and passing in old Gwalior, so we call Gwalior Gate. So Maharaja wife number 9 palace near the Gwalior Gate. And this is the palace used about the 8 wives. Mm-hmm. See the right side, here is a small hill. Mm-hmm. So this is the ammunition store, they made by the English. Inside used to put a cannon wall of gunpowder. From there is new wall, where the long hall, they made by the English. They used to fit the gunner at wartime. And behind you, there is platform, that is the sound and light platform. Evening people were sit and they watch the sound and light program. Tonight you staying in Gwalior?
No.
Maybe next time you come to visit also light and sound. It is very nice program. Because olden time only sound and light. You can listen the sound and imaging. But this time they use laser show. In the wall they using like parda. So all the queen and elephant, horses, everything you can see scenery. Like in movie. So it nowadays is very good program.